She says, 6 months later, you get engaged lying in bed on a Sunday morning. Wait, I wasn't engaged. Wait, didn't we get married? Oh, I just moved in. Oh, okay. And she wants kids, what the heck? Alright. Is the music too loud? Settings. 70. Resume. What does that mean? He runs away. Julia asks to take a different path from that day forward. You say, okay, you don't want to go that way either. Wait, does that mean she wanna break up or what? From then on, you walk by the river. I don't get it. Associate department chair. She wants to move. You absolutely do not. says that'll be hard, but she'll do it if you won't move. You tell her not to pass it up if it's what she wants. She agrees. She flies back to Boulder 3 times each semester. Only 3 times. Man. Julia is sent home from Yale on paid leave after having an episode. She lost it on a colleague for borrowing books that were important to her research. She didn't remember she had happily loaned them to him just 2 days prior. She was found crying in the stairwell. You say that maybe you guys should talk to someone about it. You make macaroni and drink wine, try to forget about it. Why forget about a problem? After seeing multiple doctors and having many tests, they are worried that Julia might be suffering from early onset dementia. She is 41. What is onset dementia? You both decide to keep it a secret for now. Okay. Journal. Whoa, okay. Easy game. Bucket is getting older. Julia comments that it's kind of nice because he gets less trouble around the house. A week later, she goes back to the university. Julia's affliction gets worse. She can't remember things in class. Her research is in shambles. She drives her car to the next town over for no particular reason and has to be brought home by the police. She is devastated. She is sent home on permanent medical leave. Dementia is when you have trouble remembering things. Some days you get to Julia, who calls you a dope and your unborn children little idiots. Other days you get a stranger. She pulls you into bed to make love. After 5 minutes she goes into a panic, believing her dad is at the door. You tell her family. They are crushed and begin to make trips to and from their home in Australia to visit her. For a while, your friends come by with little things to brighten the day. She gets worse. You spend your days following Julia around the house. You count the seconds between the 2 weekly visits from Daniel, the nurse. He suggests that Julia could live somewhere else, somewhere with 24-hour care, a home. It sits with you for a couple of months. You decide to move her into a full-time care facility. You are determined to take care of her by yourself. I mean, I can visit her, right? Damn it. Julia's sister Susan moves to Boulder to be close to her. She visits her every day. You go with her some of the time. Susan buys you an old typewriter and urges you to use it if you won't see a therapist. You won't. You've always really liked Susan. Months go by, Bucket dies. Julia doesn't remember him when you tell her. Sometimes it takes her a minute to lock in on you. In the back of your mind, you believe it's because you see her less and less. And seeing her less and less makes her forget you more. You think, originally. Okay, this is my summer job. Enter the lookout tower. Ron's just
Two Forks Tower.
Oh, I have to speak to the radio.
Two Forks Tower, this is Thoroughfare Tower. Come in.
Reply. Hold left shift to activate radio. Select dialogue. Release left shift.
Hello? Whoever this is?
It's Henry, right?
Yeah.
I'm Delilah.
Yeah, that's what the guy said on the phone.
So, what's wrong with you?
Excuse me?
People take this job to get away from something. So, what's wrong?
What's wrong with you?
I know.
That's a great idea. Go ahead.
Look, I just hiked for 2 days, so I don't really follow whatever it is you're doing right now.
You take a stab at what's wrong with me.
Fine, then can I sleep forever?
Sure, buddy. Okay, now go ahead.
You've killed 3 ex-husbands. You were playing against a mom. Nobody back home can stand you. What the hell?
You're just gonna wait me out on this? Ugh, fine.
Okay, it took too long.
But I'm gonna take a second here and have a guess about you.
Okay.
Let's see. I don't know anything about you.
I
say
song.
You got fired from your job and have finally decided to write your novel. That's the sort of bullshit reason you'll find a man out in the woods.
Good night.
Welcome to the job.
Good night. Day one.
Good morning, Henry. Well, I guess good afternoon. You probably slept like a rock. Anyway, there's still a few hours of daylight to get some work in. I can see you at your desk, so call me when you're ready.
She sees me. That's scary.
Hey, sorry. Guess I slept in.
You got a relaxing, what, 14 hours of sleep? Whew.
Yeah, Jesus.
I need to shower.
6?
6:45.
Whoops.
Don't worry about it. That hike puts everyone out of commission for a day or two. But now that you're up, let me quickly get you acquainted with the job.
Okay.
There's a thing in the middle of your room with a round map on it. Do you see it?
Hold left shift to activate radio.
Okay, yeah, I see it.
This grinder, invented in 1914 by W.B.
Osborne.
Osborne?
You use this to spot, you guessed it, fire. What the fuck?
What is it?
Fire.
Nothing. You use this to. Oh, fuck me!
Good God, language, lady.
Out your west-facing window. Are you seeing what I'm seeing?
West. West. West.
Are those fucking fireworks?
West window. West. Which way is west? And to use compass.
I need you to confirm. Do you see them?
Wait, hold on. Deja.
Seriously, are you seeing
west?
This?
That's not legal, right?
No. You need to get down there right now and stop them. Fire danger is through the fucking roof.
Is that really my job?
Your job is whatever I say it is. Look, the closest ranger is like 2 days away. Go down there.
Turn down volume.
Ticket?
Easy there, Dirty Harry.
Well?
Get going. You'll probably need a rope to get down the shale between you and the lake, if I remember right. There should be one in the supply box on the way. The code is 1234. It's actually that for all of them.
Hi. Shower, man. Okay. I just read the map. Na 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 na. Trail closed. Oh no. That's okay. Come on.
Trail. Where's that rope supposed to be?
Down the trail that leads west of your tower, so just a teensy bit south and west of you.
South. South and west. was not good at that. I was not good at directions. To turn right. How did we miss? I thought we were just supposed to follow the trail. That's the best I know. Oh, I can't do it with the map in my face, I think. Okay. That's the best I know. Oh. That reminds me of Among Us. Is that it?
Probably gonna eat it.
Where's that?
I'm at the cash box.
Hold E. Yum. Just go west. West, west, west. Can't wait for the Azazor accomplishment. At the lake. There is no lake. That one, that's so far. I hear the sound. Let's just look up. Hard to toggle jogging. Hard to toggle jogging. Oh, I probably can't do it with the map in my face. Hard. Faster. you have died. Report climbing accident.
Hey.
What the hell's wrong with you?
My rope snapped coming down the shale slide.
You didn't break anything, did you?
No, I think I'll make it.
Make
it. Careful, for Christ's sake.
Okay, Delilah. So bossy. Cliffs down here or something.
It is a hell of a nice camping spot down here by the lake.
I haven't been down there in years, but yeah, Jonesy Lake area is perfect.
West, west, west. West, west, west. East. Now we're gonna climb back up. Right. Just going east.
Last night when I welcomed you to the job.
Yeah, well, you're not the first boss to be guilty of that. years old, so I'm safe. It's not gonna strike twice and all that.
Well, there was an old lookout named Roy Sullivan who got hit by lightning 7 times.
I don't like the sound of that.
Yeah, well, if it makes you feel any better, it wasn't what killed him.
What killed him?
Suicide. Would you believe?
No.
There's some guy out here giving me the creeps.
The creeps?
Yeah, I came out of this cave in a canyon and he was just...
creeping? Wait, he's looking at you? Is he doing anything else?
I don't think so.
Henry, there's something I... something someone should have told you about this area.
Henry, quiet.
It's outside.
Come on.
Wow.
The whole thing. And people come and go as they please. It's madness.
Yeah, okay. I get it.
Look, bumping into someone in the middle of nowhere is part of the fun.
It's not like that. That's what the girl is. That's true. Hey, nice radio. Which way?
Someone broke in.
They what?
They wrecked the place. Threw my typewriter out the window. Motherfucker.
Holy shit.
Someone's cursing.
Let the Forest Service know what happened.
Will they catch whoever did it?
This is the Forest Service, Henry. They're not exactly Hawaii 5-0. Do you have any idea who would have done this?
Maybe that guy I saw in the canyon, but I don't know why the fuck he'd want to mess with my stuff.
Quiet.
I'll have the Rangers keep an eye out for a man hiking on his own and question him if they find him. I can't believe someone would do this. I worry about bears and fires, and that's about it, and... now I've got to worry about some deranged hiker going after lookouts? Great.
Okay,
in the morning I'm going to call my friend Patty, who works the desk down in Cody. They keep a list of everyone who's officially been in and out of the trailhead since, I don't know, forever, and see if we can get a list of names. We won't get
Sorry, our problem.
That storm knocked out the phone line I used to talk to the service, which means we're cut off. I tried radioing out, and that's not working either.
Well, great.
I don't really know why that would be the case.
Can I go fix it?
Well, you probably can't, but what you can do is hike out to where the wire runs through your area and report back if it's down. Then I can track down a ranger to get someone on it.
Okay, I can do that. Where is it?
You probably had to hike through a cave yesterday to get home.
Yeah, I did.
So, you're gonna want to go back there, go through it, and keep going straight to the north when you come out.
Will do.
Thanks, Hank.
Henry.
It's Henry.
What, you don't like Hank?
Yeah, I don't like Hank.
But thanks rhymes with Hank.
No, it doesn't.
Okay, alright.
I'm not Hank. Where's the cave? How do we get to the cave? Lots of map reading. Cave 452. North. Let's go north. But that's south. Southeast.
So this generator is all the power I've got out here.
Yep, it doesn't go through much gas, and, well, you don't have much in the way of electronics, so...
Yeah.
a good dog.
What type?
A beagle.
We got him from the pound.
That's great. Hey, can you hold out a sec?
Sure. Just gonna keep hiking and hoping it warms up.
Heyo. I don't think so. Why, have you?
What?
Okay, good. No, I don't think he has any idea.
What is she talking about?
I'm absolutely sure. Would you? Alright, I'll let you know if anything changes in that regard.
Not.
Hey, sorry about that. Anyway, Bucket's a cute name. You owned him with someone?
Not. This is not North.
Well, looks like I might have lost you. You could be down in one of those valleys. Call me if you need
anything. No, I wanted to talk to you. But I got lost. I'm good, okay? Not.
Wires from where you are?
I can see the poles, but I have no idea if the wire is in good shape or not. They run a good distance up to a spot called Beartooth Point. You just need to walk along them all the way up there and make sure everything's in ship shape.
Okay.
Yeah, okay, the wire's down here.
Really? Awesome. Good find.
It's like, I don't know, a mile and a half east of me. You just follow the trail up the hill, you can't miss it. I'll go see what the damage is.
Beer can. Go to, oh my god. That was scary.
Hey, so there are beer cans all over the ground up here leading up the hill.
That's annoying.
Yeah, the thing is, there were a bunch down at that campsite yesterday.
Coincidence, maybe?
I don't think so. Same brand, everything.
She's bad.
Fucking kids.
Clean up. Hold E.
So the wire is definitely down out here. I just found it. Yeah, the thing is, it doesn't look like the wind. It looks like it was cut deliberately.
Scary.
I knew it the moment you said you found their trash. These idiots are gonna pay. Do they realize this is how people die? I mean, what if something happened to one of my lookouts while this was going on?
God forbid
there's an actual fire burning out of control.
What do you want to do?
I want you to go find them.
And then what?
I haven't thought that far ahead. That's not true. Everything that comes to mind is illegal.
Let's hear it.
Oh, yeah?
Hey, I came out here for a breath of fresh air and some adventure. What do you got?
I think I want you to just find them and scare the hell out of them.
Oh, I'm good at that.
I'd make a spooky ghost costume, but they stole my sheets.
I don't know. back around towards the lake or something. I doubt they're where they were yesterday, but they obviously can't have gone far.
So scary. We don't sound like professionals. Why won't they leave us more of beer cans? So mad at me. Does it make sense? I know, right? The black cash. There should have been a backpack hanging from a tree. I can't get back. Hanging from a tree.
Well, I am flush with ropes now. That pack was full of them, in decent condition too.
That's lucky.
I mean, there's enough rope here that I could just leave them hooked up, I think. Oh, get this. This pack came with one of those cardboard single-use cameras.
Oh my god, let's see what's in the camera.
Left.
Yeah, he only used 3 or 4.
Neato.
Thank you, Brian Goodwin.
Wait, who?
The bag had the name Brian Goodwin sewn into the top.
Down there.
I'm kidding. Not about him being
Would there be a fence out here?
Because sometimes hikers go ass over tea kettle when on a trail.
So the Forest Service would put up a big chain link fence?
A chain link fence?
Yeah, it looks like it surrounds a huge area.
Huh, that's weird.
Who are they keeping out of here? Why? Those girls could be behind this fence?
Well, having once been an ornery young woman, the last thing I would do is climb a fence. Especially if I knew I was in trouble.
I don't even know how I would get in.
It's really strange that that's out there, by the way.
Yeah, it's weird.
Okay, that's helpful, Delilah. I'm scared. Feels like it. Like, is it a horror game? Toy Story. Gotcha. I gotta go where I can go. We're gonna find out.
I shouldn't be here, but I am.
I'm sorry, Henry. What is it?
We'll get into it.
Oh my god, okay. We came back.
Well, in the meantime, you are here, and it's beautiful, and escaping isn't always something bad.
Yeah, sure.
Look, I gotta go do a thing, but I'll have a radio. Okay, call me if you need to.
I'm stuck. Did the radio smoke in that south? In the sky above the cliff.
wait your turn before I bounce your face off a dumpster.
It's beautiful.
From this burned section of forest, I have no idea where to go. Their trail is pretty cold at this point.
You're out by Mule Point.
No
one would care about the fire weed. Well, I want you to stay out there as a favor to little old me.
My pleasure.
Okay, we know these young women are sloppy. They must have left some sort of trail.
Some sort of trail. You said to look up. Go to it, right? Aisha. Oh, whoops, is here too.
What does she have?
She's got Alzheimer's. Like, dementia.
Whoa. How old was she?
Is she? She's alive. She's with her family in Melbourne, Australia. She's 43.
Fuck.
Yeah.
What was it like when you guys found out?
I didn't really understand what was happening. You don't get Alzheimer's in your late 30s.
No kidding.
Quiet.
Even then, we didn't really get it until she couldn't work anymore and I couldn't leave her alone. It wasn't until then that I said, oh, this is it. This is over. That was hard. I'm sorry to be such a downer.
Don't even. I'm happy to listen. And, you know, we'll try to have some fun this summer. I promise.
I see a really thin plume of smoke.
Yeah, I see it too. A thin plume like this is either a new fire or a campfire.
Campfire? You think it's them? It looks like it's to the southwest of me.
That's right. If you hike towards Five Mile Creek, that should put you in the neighborhood. Keep an eye on that smoke plume. Let me know if it's getting any larger.
Will do.
I will do. Thank you.
walked over and asked her what her major was because I thought she was a student, not a prof.
Smooth.
That's me. I did make the first move, though.
Aw, you were brave.
I was drunk.
How do I get there? Smooth criminal.
Maybe I'll go visit. I don't know.
Oh, why not? She's in Australia.
She's with her family in Melbourne. They're not big fans of mine.
Oh.
Her sister, Susan, is great, but her parents, I think they always thought she could do better, and that I could have done a better job looking after her.
United States.
Fuck that. I have no doubt you did your best.
I don't know.
If you want to go visit her, you should go. Don't let a couple of assholes keep you away from someone you love.
I'll think about it. Boy, for as dry as it is this summer, there's an area down here that's lush.
Oh, you must be talking about the Aspen Grove down there.
Yeah, I think that's where I am.
Those trees are actually one root organism. Did you know that?
I didn't.
Yeah, they share their water as a colony that can live for hundreds of years, even through fire. Can you believe you're actually getting paid to learn all of these amazing things? Also, by what it looks like on this map, you'll be coming up on a stream that should lead you towards where we saw that smoke.
Stream. Where am I? Camp helps your right follow the stream.
It's a really nice waterfall down here. Given those girls love a skinny dipping, I bet they're nearby.
Nearby.
Demolished.
You're there? Where are they?
I don't know. Gone. This whole place is torn apart.
What happened?
The hell?
Honestly, it looks like it could have been a bear.
Oh, Jesus.
Okay, I need to be honest with you. If I find a dead body out here, I'm gonna be sick.
I'm gonna be sick.
Well, don't yak. Just look around and let me know what you find. Actually, you forgot that camera, right?
Are all torn up.
That's not good.
You know, maybe I should take one of their sleeping bags as payback.
At this stage, take whatever you want.
Wow. They were attacked and I'm taking stuff from them. Oh, I'm not going to. Okay. Read. Dear Psycho. I guess it's a good timing to call it a day for us to. What's day two? Thank you guys so much for tuning
Henry?
In to let us talk to us.
What do you look like?
What do I look like? I look like Santa Claus.
Because I'm horribly superficial.
Hey, Chris.
I could be Tom Cruise's good-looking twin brother.
Make sure you shave in the
middle. I heard that people is like 5'0".
Yeah, well, you can't win them all.
Okay, well, that gives me a good start. Now let's see. In my scope, I can only tell you're a white guy with...
guess that's getting old.